things are come. Was Jesus himself who spoke a word and storms obeyed him?
Sitting down.
people and tell them it's just great to be in the presence of God. September 2017, we have come to this month that ends with either September, November, December, October. It is a great month. I don't know how they all ended up the same alphabetical setup, but he knows, and it's so crucial. It is a moment of check and balance. If it is a business you open for the past 6 months from January, by now you must have begun to see signs of where you're going. If it is a school, by now you begin to adjust yourself within the environment. Whatever you are doing after 6 months, by now, you begin to know what is happening. So this is a crucial moment, and I want to thank God for the life of every one of you. This remaining few months before the end of the year is very crucial in the sense that at the end of the year there must be accountability. We'll be able to assess all the promises of God. It was surprising. You're already in heaven. That's what church is all about. You say you are a chosen generation. I call out people. Try to tell them what church is. A group of saints, ecclesiastics, those who are called out for a specific purpose. So God extended his territory here on earth through the church, which is like an embassy. Because if you go to German embassy in any country, you're already in Germany. They operate every system they operate here. Amen?
Amen.
So you're already there, preparing to be taken up. And according to 1 Thessalonians, they also made mention that on the last day, they that are here, we who are believers, who are alive, and they that are already dead in Christ, they will be caught up together. They will rise and be caught up together for rapture and meet us, and we together will, like a cloud, will not go to Father. So we are already in heaven. Amen?
Amen.
That's why when you come to church, exercise the principle that heaven is all about. And I told them, what do you think that when we go there, you think we eat ever? You think we eat donkoro, cake, and so on, or all those, you know. We won't eat all those ever, all those egusi and all this. You will see it. You're not eating food there. Our food will be different, amen?
Amen.
He said, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost is the food there. This praise we are having. So when you exercise those things, you're already in heaven. And be packed. That's why when you come, don't just wait, dance to the glory of God. Rejoice, because that's what they're going to do in heaven. I want to just share something with you that will encourage us to wake up. It's a moment of awakening. It's a moment of for us to wake up. You know, I have come to realize that many of us as believers, one of the things that is taking us away from God is the pursuit of things of the world. We are so much occupied, especially here in Europe, we are too busy for things of God. And that is why there is so much less in the manifestation of power of God. Because, you know, the way we take the things of God, we take priority first of earthly things. And when we take priority of earthly things, then God becomes secondary. Then we now also, try to do everything Then at the end, we felt that it is by my power. Then we felt that it is me, but it's not you. It is not about how much you labored or how much you struggled. It is good to work hard. I am one of those who love working hard. But God should be the center person in our heart and in our life. It's very, very important. It's the key to everything. And that is why we struggle and suffer a lot. Because of doing away with the first thing we're supposed to look for, and then going after what we all live here one day. Until we come to the place to understand that in all our getting, we should get wisdom. Wisdom of God. To know what to seek first and to know what to do first. If hard working was the promotion to acquiring things, then my mother in the village could have been one of the richest. Hello? Because I don't know if any of us here, this is not a joke, can walk what a woman can do. And their own mothers also. They carry things, they labor, they, you know, struggle, they till the land. Only just to send her to school, maybe. Hardly to change anything. But it is God that causes blessings and open doors. And that is why so many of us here have struggled so much here. Did everything within their best, and they're asking themselves, oh God, what else should I do? God said, because you have taken that as your first priority, then I let you handle things yourself. And when you're tired, the whole power is gone. Maybe you have just one or few things that you think you have acquired. It's not about maybe children and husband and all those things. At the end, you still have no people who have all those things and see they are not happy. You ask yourself, what is happening? Happiness can only come from God. When you begin to appreciate the little God has given to you. If you are riding a bicycle, thank God for it. You are just happy. To create more happiness than someone who is living in Buckingham Palace. Believe me. Find out that it's not about money. It's not about all this. Our limited happiness. They come, they move. But when you find God, when you are okay where God has put you, you find out that your happiness will be peace. You eat just a place where meat, even if it is a, like here I would say, added day bread. You eat and not a grocery with a miracle grocery. You're happy. You're just happy. You eat it, you know that kind of bread that you soak inside a bovina. Hello? Some of you are too Polish. You don't do those kind of things again. Amen. You soak it inside bovina. Which who sends you kind of God? Amen. And you're just happy with plastic on. Abba. This is what people are doing here. They are all rich, 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 rich people. Hallelujah. You are so happy. You drink it. You know, I am more happy than someone who was sad with God. This and that. You are just happy. You feel good. Believe me. More happy. It's not about the quality or the things. It's about the joy you have. And it comes from God. It didn't come only from God. Amen? Some little, little things. That is why we are more happier in Africa. Yeah? December time, what do they buy? Heavy, many, very day.
and gave me a list. I nearly divorced the mother. Hallelujah. How can a whole taxi driver not sending me to buy all these things? And they are simply telling you that if you don't buy it, then you don't measure. How? Praise God. I'm telling you, buy it. I don't even know what it's called, birthday. December time. I'm telling you. And I will never want to warn anybody. It's about that they buy that glass that is where you look at it. How much? Buy bicycle, special, suit, only for one person birthday. Hallelujah. But what am I trying to say is, the same thing we check with their children, but the same way it goes with adults, until you begin to appreciate God and be happy with whatever you have, that is where God heaven is upon.
Are you hearing me, somebody?
The funniest thing now, if you now go and buy the old type of Volkswagen, they now see you now as a rich person. That thought is crazy. Now it's the latest in town. If you are riding it, or old type of messages, if they see you, say, wow, this is a rich man. See how like this? Appreciate God for who, wherever you are. Fine. If you still put you in pussy, cherish that pussy. Cherish it. And overcome it with laughter and joy. Sing a new song in it. It is not about how much you're making. It is about wisdom and hands of God being upon that money. He will multiply it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go to the Bible somehow. Romans 8. Tell somebody be spiritual. That is what I'm teaching. To be spiritual. Romans 8 will read 6-10. Spiritually minded is life and peace. For to be carnally minded is what? Death. And but to be spiritually minded is life and peace, because the carnal mind is a enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To be carnally minded is what? Death. Because everything flesh, the mind, is present. It causes war against us. And no matter whatever you think about it, all that we are all struggling to do on this earth is three things. Eat, house, and clothes. Finish. To eat, where to put our head, and what to wear. These are the three major aspects why we kill ourselves. It is good when God blesses you with an extra ordinary abundance. That's why sometimes, sorry to say it, when I look at our politicians sometimes, I say these people are just, I don't think they are human beings. I can't imagine it. You have 100 million in hard currency in a third world country and you are still not certified. You have houses. And at the night, when night comes, you can only sleep in one bed. You can't wear two clothes at the same time, otherwise you become a Uber. This comedian that will wear double clothes, when you ask him to pull off, he will pull more than 10 clothes away from his body. Otherwise you become a comedian. People see you like this, if you wear one as I am here, like, can you imagine I wear another one, and all of a sudden I'm preaching here. Some of you will just be looking at me and laughing and saying, is he crazy? But that's what we do. You can, no matter how, you can never live more than in a one bedroom when you die, I want to go to bed. And the funny thing is, guess what they do? When all at your house, it's only a couch at your parlor you sleep sometimes. So I begin to wonder why all this, and all this in order to get there, is what we are killing ourselves every day. We are all struggling. Pushing by all means, killing each other, stabbing each other in the back, just to have position in order to get those things. Finish. Nothing. I am not telling you that to have them is evil. But I am telling you that first and foremost, seek you first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Everything you are looking for, life will be easy for you. Yes. Seek you first. You know, we, thank you, Lord. 98% of us teach our children A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, 1, 2, 3, 4. You must know book. If you don't know book, it's like we should do the operation and put book inside and cover it. Must know book, you must be doctor, you must be engineer. We must, that we force them. Many of us don't force them to learn how to pray. We hardly teach them how to pray. We never teach them how to kneel down and seek God. And the Bible says, seek you first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And every other thing will be added. It will come. We never get time to have that time to really sit down with them and say, I want to teach you about God. Harry had his birthday. The mother is like, pray for him this time. Master said, cool down, woman. The time will come. I didn't just want to pray for him. Sometimes if I pray for him, you may not even understand. You may not take him far. When I get time, when I get the time, I sat him down. I said, you may come. Can I talk to you? I said, yes. I said, do you have time? I said, yes. Are you in a hurry? He said, no. I said, what do you do in church? Every Sunday, you speak Hebrew. I said, do you know that that thing is not entertainment? You are worshiping God. I begin to open his understanding to understand what he's doing and how. I said, do you pray always on your own? I said, how do you pray? I said, what do you pray when you pray? Say, if she must have Friday, Father, please help me at us. Help me at us. Help me at us. I said, no, change your prayer. I said, that's all you spent. I said, listen, whenever you are praying, ask God to reveal yourself to me. Let me know you. Can I have a personal encounter with you? Let me know who you are. Please, if you are truly God, reveal yourself to me. I said, when God reveals himself to you, when you play like attending us,
You play from heart. I say, henceforth, in all your understanding, get wisdom about God. Know the Father you are worshiping. Know the Son. Say, everything you seek, it will come. But no matter how you read, how you learn, you don't even know what you are going to be. It's hidden. But if you find God, who is your maker, you'll find your purpose. For that purpose, we look for the article itself. Look at this. That we are coming to a time when your purpose in life is going to begin to expose. That if you don't take time, you will run past it. It will come and you will run past it in pursuit of it, but it is already in you. But if you know him, he will direct your goal. He will direct your path. He will show you where to go. You know when you are made, because there is a fear in you about God. That you have come to know that you can no longer do things anyhow. Because the way you can buy one handkerchief and tie in your head. I saw Henry come inside the house with something tied on his head. I said, what's that for? I said, I don't think you want to know. No. So, and I asked him, you bought one for himself and buy one for Heike. I said, okay. You know what? They say, if it is something good, they say, is it something good then? Then buy me one too. Hallelujah. And let us all tie it and go out to the barn of my men with salt. Hallelujah. I said, buy one. That's good. You know? So let's buy it. So, he said, look at yourself in the mirror, man. I said, okay, no one, you will tie it and come and play for us in church. I said, then if you are ashamed to wear it in the church, then it's not fit on your head. And then dismissed it. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
You don't need beauty, you don't need shouting, you don't need making noise. Tell him the reality of life. And he will drop it. Because of what? The fear of God is already in him. It's building already. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So to be carnal minded is dead. It doesn't produce anything good. And that is why in the church we refuse to grow. We refuse to understand that we are the light. Man of God was talking about this morning in the Sunday school. He said, it's the character. It's about who we are. He said, we become the epistle for the world. The world doesn't need to read the Bible, they read us.
Yes.
Oh, somebody.
Yes, sir.
They read us. Are you understanding me? One thing I have come to understand in this world, that everybody wants something good. I have never seen an arm robber who, after operation, take the money and give to the fellow arm robber, keep for me. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
To tell you that they know. They find somewhere that money will be saved and give to. Can I provoke you? No man who runs after women up and down will ever marry and allow you to stay close to the wife. And I'm telling you the truth. They carry their own daughter. They carry their own wife. So they know it's wrong. So nobody doing evil will like evil to happen to him. So we should be careful.
dancing, I'm praising God. He said, ah, I said, this little dog drinks. You know, it's like we are drunk already. What is the drink of the Holy Spirit?
Yes.
It is the Holy Spirit. Those days, Shabbat, so on. Raphael, come along. Oh, don't joke with me. Now, I know that you come on stage, I'll bring you down. Praise God. Don't joke with me. Hallelujah. So we dance and we're happy. Thank God. But we're still believers at that time. We are still Christians, you know. We are still Christians. But too much carnality. Too much carnality. Unto the revelation of the knowledge of Christ hits us. And so our eyes were enlightened and opened. So wow. Now, do you know before, when I'm hearing songs, like they are singing songs, I don't even know the topic. I don't know the meaning. I don't read the words. All I know is Jesus, yeah, so, you know, some foundation. I don't even think what I'm singing. All I know is just the reading that I'm following. I was full of kind. Come to this world. Wow. Be not conformed. That's to hold close, to hold tight to the things of God. But be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Many of us are walking as believers, are still walking into dangers. We are walking and being trapped. Because we are too much conformed to the things of God. So even when God is speaking, don't even hear. Oh.
Yes.
Even when God is warning you over a situation, leave that girl alone. Leave that man alone. It's enough. Don't travel here for real. Don't dare try this business. You can, because you're too much conformed to the things of the world. He said, but be you transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may know what is the perfect will of God concerning you.
Hallelujah.
There are things, because you are conformed to the world, when you watch it on television, you laugh. It gives you a kind of form. Oh, Father, thank you. And you become passionate to it. Listen, it is not only pornographic materials that is promised sexually. When you continue to watch accidents and what is happening and things that is happening, listen, before you know it, the spirit of fear will enter you. And when the spirit of fear enters you, your tongue will change. Anything you are thinking is negative. I don't want to die, no. Everything for you will be death. Accident. This will happen. I don't go there. Something you're not supposed to be afraid of, all of a sudden, you're afraid. Even somebody said, let me go. Many things, a lot of things. How do we manage to monitor our wife, husbands, every step they take? You never cross again from what we see. Faith comes from what?
Hearing, yeah.
Seeing, smelling. So by the time you hear, you see, it downloads every message into your heart. So even your husband becomes a suspect because you watch always on television negative things. Who divorced, how they make problem, how this will come, how it become their total chapter. And before you know it, you are no longer free. You are no longer free, you are locked up. Everything is suspect. Even when somebody is telling good money, watch this money. Are you sure it's from the house? And other things. Before they give you nice food, Father, in the name of Jesus, I bind, I cast. somebody does not give you. Because of what you have been watching. So any little thing, bam, Jesus. One thing, bam. The thing can register so much through watching. See, you never believe anybody again. Do not be conformed to this world, but be you transformed by the renewing of your mind. In what? In the word of God. That you may know what is the perfect will of God concerning you. I'm not preaching today, God will bless you, but I'm giving you information that will help you, help your family, help you personally grow. To be kind of, this is the one. You see, we are the epistle that people are reading. It is important that we should understand this kingdom we are in. It is not about dressing, it is not about what you have, but it's about the power that is in you. It is about the power that is in you. You don't argue, you don't talk, but the people will see Christ in you. They will see Christ in you. So I want to challenge all of us. It is time for us to be believers and be believers. Exercise the spirit. Spiritual things and see the manifestations of things before man and before woman. You will see the manifestations. You see God dealing with us in truth. He said, I did not call you to follow me in vain. We must exercise this God. We must believe him. Get rid of all those things that hold you back. I have no one day shaking that my tomorrow is going to be better than my today. You didn't hear me?
Yes, sir.
That is how God has planned it. My tomorrow is better than my today. Because the Bible says that you shall be like a tree planted by the rivers. That the season and out of season will bear what fruit. He said that the ways of the ways of a believer is like the morning sun that transcends brighter and brighter and brighter and brighter and brighter into the noonday. We don't begin with shining. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The morning's winter does not begin immediately and start shining. But as the day moves on, it becomes brighter. It become brighter.
Yes,
it become brighter.
Yes,
tell somebody, you have never seen the better of me.
You have never seen the better of me.
Oh, you have never seen my best.
You have never seen my best.
Hallelujah. You have never. Never. David said, he said, Mark a perfect man. Watch him. He said, watch a perfect man. His end is good.
Oh, yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, our suffering now is not anything to be matched with the blessings of tomorrow. You see, that is it. So, you should understand that it is going to be better. And better.
Amen.
What God just wants you to do is focus on him. Open your heart to him. Seek him first, and the rest shall be added to
him.
It can never get worse.
Amen.
It can never, ever get worse. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Father, I give you praise.
Hallelujah.
I thank you. Let me tell you what unbelievers do. And I don't want you to be part of it. Luke chapter 2 and verse 20. And then we'll close. But God said unto him, thou fool, this night thy soul shall be required of thee. Then who shall those things be which thou hast provided? I want to accommodate this, as if they will take the whole thing to heaven. Last time I told you here, I said, in heaven there is no Dutchman, no dollars, no euro, they don't trade or don't do. The way God is too big to use their local currency.
Yes, sir.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Oh, look at how they are looking
yes,
at
sir.
German self, no use Niger currency. Come to the creator, yeah? The Almighty. Are you understanding me?
Yeah.
No matter how beautiful, how our currency in Nigeria look like, we got the head of our former head. German don't need it. Are you getting it? If you bring it here, it's counterfeit. So that is how God does not need their money in heaven. He have better money.
Hello.
He have better things for you. He have already put things in place. We only use those currencies here to solve some few problems. And this man was loading himself with, accommodating and loading and loading and loading. Oh, and his mind was centered on those things he was making. And God said, listen, tonight they are coming.
Yes.
Whom are you living on? Let me see who we are living. The funniest thing is, most of the time, the things we leave, our children run them down. Mostly. Because they never level for it. They don't know what it takes. Only very few. They are mine. From the things of God. You see God from God means. Will meet your needs. He will make your children to prosper. Believe me. They will never beg for bread. I pray that we come to this knowledge and stop this husband. I didn't say don't walk. I didn't say don't make that mistake. The pastor said go and sleep and be at home. No. But I'm saying to you, whatever you are doing, talk to God first every day of your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's be on our feet. The one we spoke today, if we make up our minds to seek Him in Christ Jesus, it takes a man who is living spiritually to speak like that. Paul said, one thing that I ever desire, that I may know Him and the power of His resurrection, that I may know God. With all His knowledge, Elijah saw Elisha. He threw away all that he has to follow Elijah. Peter left all his pursuits over fish and fishing magnets to follow Christ, and his life was never the same again. Even in prison, God sent an angel to remove him. He left all his ways and followed Christ. When he tried to go back by his own power, he did not catch anything. He went again back crossing. I want to pray to you that God Almighty will open your eyes to see these things as I'm seeing them. Open your eyes to understand that it's not about anybody, but it is about knowing God personally one to one. As I teach my family, so I teach you. That in all you are getting, get the wisdom and knowledge of God. Train your children. Emulate me as I emulate Christ. And it shall be well with you.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for such a great and precious time. I give you all glory and I give you all the honor. I thank you for a moment of understanding that to leave Canaan is death. It is wrong. It is insufficient and never enough. It is a race that never comes to an end. It is pain
Even when there is abundance, we still struggle to have more. Let what we have be enough for us.
Amen.
And let's seek you first. Let's go after you. We are living in a time that without money, you are nobody. Without wealth, you are nobody. But God, I still stand in that principle that if I have you, I have everything. That your name is enough for me. It will give me strength to carry on. It will bless me in times of trouble. It will direct my path. It will help me to love and show love. It will help me to forgive. Daddy, I thank you. Pray for your people, Lord. In their pursuit, may they never forget you. In their running for wealth and trying to make life, may they still hold you as their number one. Patient of ages, we are not here by our own self. It is you that brought all this far. It is you. And you said, they that call upon your name shall never be put to shame. Father, we shall never be put to shame.
Amen.
You will meet all our needs.
Amen.
You will crown us with victory. You will bless the little.